pornography, masturbation, temptation. Speaking particularly about pornography, masturbation, and just sexual lust is what this is going to be about. I remember my time spent being addicted to pornography. Praise God, I've been free from that for 3 years now, which is why this is a huge passion of mine to speak on this. Pornography is such a trap. Lust is such a trap. And the temptations that lead us there are something we are going to talk about, and talk about facing those, and facing those head on through the power of Christ, not of self. So why do we face temptation? I think we face temptation because of who we are as humans. I mean, if we viewed every situation in a perfect outcome and a perfect circumstance, would we be mad? Would we feel stressed? Would we be depressed? Would we want to turn to porn? Would we want to turn to these temptations through our day? No, but the point is that we are naturally in a sin state. So we face temptation because of who we are. It's part of life. And there's lessons to be learned by this temptation. One of the biggest things I ever learned by looking at my pornography temptation is who I was as an individual. I had a lot of masked issues. Pornography was just this one issue. Surface level, what was really going on? That's typically how it is. And there's so many lessons to be learned in that. I remember when I first started to unwrap this package one piece at a time. Ah, there it is. A broken heart. Abandonment. Feeling inadequate. Whatever it is, the point is that there's always a lesson God's trying to teach us, and that we can teach ourselves through these temptations. So what did Christ say about temptation? That's something we're going to reflect on and read a story in today in Matthew 4. He said a lot about it, and he also did a lot about it. The number one thing he did was die in our place. So that God doesn't see us as our temptation, he sees us as his son. No matter how many times we fall into this temptation, or this temptation overcomes us, Christ has overcome everything. So, yeah. So how can we better face temptation? Every person will battle with temptation is the thing. The best way to face it is to face it. I remember being caught up in that porn cycle, like, ah, man, I have 7 days strong, 1 day fall. I'm going to identify with this temptation and with this with this desire. Grab some water. And I'm just going to, that's going to be my identity. Instead of fighting it off, I just wallowed in it. And the way to fight these things off is one battle at a time. I mean, I love the UFC personally. Sorry. I do. Some people love football, just as violent, just only have pads, just as political, just kidding, kind of. But I love the UFC, and I noticed that these fighters, they put their heart and their soul into it. They go out there swinging. Doesn't mean they're going to win. I think Christ is looking for warriors. He's looking for warriors to face this temptation. And warriors come in all genders. Male or female. There's only two, by the way. Sorry, I don't want to imply anything weird. That's a different spectrum. But male or female warriors. And he's looking for those people. He's looking for people to get in there and do battle with Satan. And sometimes we're going to fail the temptation. But the point is like I'm saying, don't wallow in the failure. Know that Christ has already succeeded despite your failure. And you'll rise. Because Christ rose. So every person can fight temptation by prayer and practice. Practice the fight. I remember falling so many times when I was first getting into this new cycle of wanting to overcome porn, and had to start putting filters on my phone. I still have those filters. I'm still fighting. Even if I think I've won, it's a lifelong battle. You never reach a point in your faith where you can be like, I used to struggle with that, not no more. No, you think things every day. It's your actions that speak your heart. So prayer and practice. I think reading the word every day, I know it's like an old cliche thing, but old cliches seem to work. Having a good foundation of the word and a good foundation of prayer. God, please help me through this day. I know I'm going to be tempted, but I know that through your Son, through the power of the Holy Spirit, I can overcome these barriers and these obstacles. So that's what I would say. So we're going to talk about how every person can fight lustful temptation. Fight. Once again, fighting means you may fail. Keep fighting. By applying lifestyle changes and scriptures to their everyday life. Scriptures. Scriptures is huge, like I was saying. What creates a good house? A good foundation. Christ talked about this. Those who build their faith on the solid rock of the word will not be quickly swept away. They will be like a rock on their foundation. Let us not build our faith where we can get choked out. Let us not build our faith where we will quickly forget it. Let us build it on the rock. So I'd say for the first thing we're going to look at, it's Matthew 4, verses 1 through 4. And it says, then Jesus was led by the Spirit into the desert to be tempted by the devil. After fasting 40 days and 40 nights, he was hungry. Jeez, go figure. The tempter came to him and said, if you are the Son of God, tell these stones to become bread. I mean, who doesn't like a good slice of bread? Jesus answered, it is written, man does not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of God. Thank you, Jesus. That is so true. So to me, what is that saying? Is that, okay, Jesus overcame the temptation of the flesh to feed itself. We can look at this as just like, okay, Jesus overcame being hungry. Yes. But can we overcome our hunger? My hunger to look at porn? The devil can look at me instantly and say, Mikey, you've been fasting for 3 years. Don't you just want a piece of bread? Don't you just want to taste it in your mouth? Don't you just want that satisfaction? Funny thing about bread, especially some good bread. I don't know if you've ever been to Red Lobster, but they got some of the best bread I've ever had. Garlic and cheddar cheese biscuits. I don't want just one of those. I want like 10. See, the point I'm making here is that porn can be like some cheddar cheese biscuits. It'll be real satisfying, but it is never going to fulfill you. You can never have enough. So what does Christ do in this moment? He says no. What should we do in those moments? Say no because they're not healthy. But say no to the porn. Say no to the temptation to feed ourselves because we're hungry. Hunger can be such a controlling thing. An appetite. An appetite isn't always good. So on to the next passage here, Matthew 5 through 7, still in chapter 4. Then the devil took him to the holy city and had him stand on the highest point of the temple. If you are the Son of God, he said, throw yourself down. Okay, that just sounds crazy anyway. For it is written, he will command his angels concerning you, and they will lift you up in their hands, so that you will not strike your foot against the stone. Gravity is not real, I guess, to Satan. Jesus answered him, it is also written, do not put the Lord your God to the test. Okay, so there are so many cans of worms in this thing. To me, what's going on here is that the devil is looking at Satan, and he's saying,